Welcome to 10 News. First tonight, Victoria's bushfire emergency, and Gippsland residents have faced a firestorm. A huge, fast-moving front that flared early this morning and forced residents, holidaymakers and at times fire crews to flee. The blaze started about 200 kilometres east of Melbourne, spreading across more than 40,000 hectares. In its path, the little towns of Seaton, Glenmaggie, Licola and Coongulla. Our cameras witnessed the ferocity and the damage as farms and houses were engulfed. Beginning our coverage, Candice Wyatt, who joins us live from Hayfield, where emergency crews are being marshalled. Candice, how many homes have been lost?
Stephen, at this point, the CFA says it's simply too early to know, but they're estimating they've lost at least five houses in the Seaton area. But they say residents of that town won't be allowed back in to assess the damage until they determine that it's absolutely safe. At the moment, there are trees burning there still, and there are many covering the road. Now, tragically, there are also reports that somebody may have died in that fire at Seaton. One resident is believed to have perished there, but the CFA is still getting details on that, and of course that would be an absolute tragedy. The CFA says their crews have also suffered today. Their safety has been a primary concern. They've battled not only this fire but 80 kilometre winds, and at one point a tanker at Seaton suffered a burnover. That's when the fire turns around and goes over the tanker. Luckily the crew is safe and the tanker is as well. Now, as you mentioned, this fire has now burnt through 40,000 hectares, and crews here say conditions are just about as bad as they could ever be. It started as an ember attack, but quickly took hold. The bushfire's ferocious appetite slowly devouring an entire house. Someone's home reduced to a smouldering mess. Seaton has borne the brunt of this fire under attack from 3:30 this morning. By 6 a.m, the blaze had grown from 950 hectares to more than 20,000. At least one family found themselves trapped in their home, but managed to escape at the last minute. Firefighters hoped a wind change this morning would bring some relief. It did, but only for a short time. With the wind shift to southwest, new threats emerged in Glenmaggie. The flames unpredictable and fierce as they tore through trees, heading towards holiday homes at a caravan park.
Jump in the car. Jump in the car now. OK, mate.
Yet as the fire front approached and visibility was reduced, some still didn't seem fazed. One man tried to save property with just a garden hose, although it was clearly too late.
Get back here! Get back here.
He finally relented, taking refuge at the edge of Lake Glenmaggie with family while the property was left to burn. On the other side of the lake, the glow of the blaze loomed, eerie and unpredictable. This is the bank of Lake Glenmaggie at Coongulla. The fire front is just on the other side of this lake, but the strength of the wind is blowing debris from the fire over to this side. Locals say they've never seen conditions like this.
It's unbelievable to see the whole sky light up, and we knew it was heading this way, and then the wind came and sort of took it towards Hayfield and all them areas over there.
13 water bombing aircraft, including Elvis, attacked the fire from the air, the fire front spotting a kilometre ahead of itself, putting houses in its destructive path at Glenmaggie.
We are not going to stop it.
Yep.
So what I want you to do,
yep,
we're just going to protect the ember attack.
Yep.
Residents sheltered by the water waiting for the fire to pass as it engulfed outbuildings. And with so much dry bushland and many areas inaccessible, firefighters are preparing for the long haul.
Given the amount of forest that's now burning, we expect to be here for certainly over a week in time.
The cause of the fire is unknown, but it's possible it was started by a campfire. Now, the CFA's attention has turned to the little town of Licola. It's nestled in a valley about 50 kilometres north of here at Hayford. There's only one road in and one road out, and as we understand, about 10 residents have chosen to stay. The fire is currently heading in their direction. The CFA has deployed a strike team, so it's a watch and wait situation there. Stephen.
OK, thank you, Candice. Candice Wyatt reporting live from Hayfield in Gippsland.